No one here is settling. Here at Sacred Heart, you get to work with some of the finest doctors in the country.
Out of my way! I got a doozy of a toozy!
Sometimes when we're in the writer's room and we're stuck on a scene in particular and we're struggling to make it funny, we'd open the weapons chest. And what we're referring to is on Scrubs, we have an arsenal of secondary characters that are all funny in their own unique way. There's Todd, the high-fiving surgeon, Jordan, Nurse Roberts, Ted Buckland, and there's Doug Murphy.
Yes! Suck on that!
Doug wanted me to give this patient 500,000 milligrams of morphine. I thought I'd check with you before I killed a man.
We love Aloma, who plays Nurse Roberts. She's gotten many laughs on the show just by saying, which is on the page, and she says it with such attitude.
Nurse Roberts is a no-nonsense, know-it-all nurse.
I think it's from that attitude that helps all her joke score.
Junior, I don't know what you're doing in my area, but you better be looking for some bandages, because you're going to need them when I get through with you.
I have no fear of anybody up in here, okay? Dr. Gilson don't scare me neither. I'm not thinking about him. Oh, this does not end well for you.
Immediately after the pilot, she was a writer's favorite, was someone we were able to bring in and, you know, have in a scene and immediately give the scene an extra layer of comedy.
I graduated first in my class at Stanford in 1972.
You graduated 12th in your class in 1968.
She Googled your ass. I love that they write for me. They give me the good lines, you know, and I like that they recognize that I can deliver those lines for them. Y'all keep writing.
We thought having an incompetent, nervous doctor who never really got over the hump as an intern would be really kind of a funny comedic gag for us in the early seasons.
Don't worry, Doug, you're a good doctor.
I know!
Doug ends patient lives. I don't think he's ever had a patient that lived through his diagnosis.
I got to a certain point in season 4 where we're like, you know, he's a doctor now, and we want some level of reality in this show, and would this character really have a job at a real hospital?
So we did a story where he was in the morgue and he'd seen every possible thing that could go wrong because he'd done it.
I'm betting he took a paracentesis needle to the aorta.
Have you seen this before?
Seen it? Upstairs, they call that a Doug.
And then we had a new character, a cocky pathologist.
He's better as a pathologist trying to figure out how patients died rather than working with patients and trying to keep them alive.
Doctor prescribed overdosage of fentanyl. Dissected left main during a cardiac catheterization.
But it's nice to have a character like that find his calling. And the one real concern all the writers had when we decided to do that story about Doug being banished to the morgue, so to speak, was will we ever see him again?
I don't know how it happened again, but it did.
I broke both my heels ski jumping, and then I called up the producers and told them I would probably have to see them next year because I was completely incapacitated. They called me 2 weeks later and said, we think that's a very Doug Murphy thing to do, so we're going to write it into the actual episode.
So we just put 2 casts on him and said that a corpse fell on him.
Dr. Murphy, I'd have more sympathy if this were the first time you broke both your feet working in the morgue.
Sir, it's like those corpses are out to get me.
If only.
We felt that an overworked, incompetent, just sweaty attorney be a key piece for stories, and I think Sam's the ultimate sad sack.
We're all going to die!
Ted is the lawyer, but he really knows nothing about being a lawyer. But he is the lawyer. Go figure.
Here's Ted, our brilliant hospital attorney, sharp as a tack.
Mark my words, Jake, we're gonna take every last cent you have.
No, Ted, we're on his side.
Oh.
Ted is obviously this incredibly neurotic lawyer who is almost on the verge of suicide.
If you need some happy pills, they're in the top drawer.
In this hellhole, I'll need a gun.
Bottom left.
Sam is confident enough in himself that he can play a character like that, and I think it's that confidence, ironically, that allows him to play a character like that so well.
So you're saying it had nothing to do with my impotence?
This season, it was fun because Ted got to fall down a lot. Juliana Margulies makes him sweat a little hard, and he slips on the board table.
Ted?
Whenever you're ready, Nina. First off, I'd just like to say that these charges...
he did that stunt himself. We didn't have a stunt man, and he sold it. It was so real. I think I've never laughed so hard after a take. And he's not that different in real life than his character. He'll say, Chris, how did you like that take?
That's so unlike me in real life. I mean, that's not me, folks. That ain't me.
My wife plays Dr. Cox's ex-wife and became one of the weapons. She is a edgy, nasty woman that says the things that comedy writers always wish they could say.
Thanks for that.
Keep moving, fetus face.
Krista has the ability to do this without making her a completely hateful character.
Look, Attila, there's no way in hell that I'm gonna listen to you complain about the rest of your life for the rest of my life. You got that?
Yeah, not listening. So I come in just to really annoy people, mostly, and say funny things and get to say whatever I want to anyone all the time. That's fun to do, to have no tact whatsoever.
Are you just gonna roll over like that?
That's weird. I asked him the same thing last night.
Where's the outrage, the anger, the hate?
Again, last night.
You've gone soft.
Okay, now it's getting spooky. Because she can say anything and do anything, she doesn't like other people not to be treated well or unfairly.
Go get in the backseat of my car and lie down on the floor.
Okay.
Nina? Ward?
When we did the Juliana Margulies arc, one of the things we thought was funny about it was if Jordan met her match.
You got something to say? Say it.
The essence of drama, and also the essence of comedy, is conflict. So much so that we turned it into a sword fight.
Julianne accidentally whacked Krista on the finger.
My finger just blew up to this big.
Krista, you know, she knuckled up, she was strong, and we finished the show.
Well, Jordan so far has fake boobs. She talks about them all the time. Guess what I found?
My grandfather's purple heart.
Please. I sold that years ago to pay for these. And she gets lots of Botox. And I think she over-Botoxed that one time and had no expression.
Oh! I think you separated my shoulder. The pain is excruciating.
What?
And Rob is an old buddy of mine, a stand-up comic and actor who I've known for years and years.
Dr. Reed, at your service.
I worked with Bill Lawrence 15 years ago, and we would go do stand-up together. I was much more of a performer, and he was much more of a writer.
When we were younger single boys, he had this side to him.
That was weird.
The Todd is a jockey frat boy surgeon who thinks he's God's gift to women.
I went out with this girl. She was like the worst first date ever. I take her for a romantic ferry ride, and for some reason, I decide to take it out.
Okay, your turn is done.
He thinks he's the life of the party wherever he is. And most importantly, he has no understanding of how other people see him.
Nurse, suction.
The patient's not even here yet.
I know.
It enables us to take an off-color joke in the writer's room and just put it in the mouth of a character and actually get it on TV.
Thong! Face five! Oh yeah!
The writers have come up with so many different kind of high fives for my character. I am literally the high five guy.
Assistant five. Fist five.
Tough break five.
Make it stop five. I'm not giving up on this guy. Prop his hand up.
What?
I said prop his hand up.
And that became known as the Miracle Five.
Oh yeah.
It's fun to be able to have those weapons, as we call them, at our disposal.
I really think that people are tuning in to watch Scrubs episodes for these guys as much as they are the main cast.
You keep the energy up by having such a strong supporting cast.
It's just that you just bring them in just for a little, you know, like that, and it's just so much fun.